You know, it's got good balance. I think, again, last year probably in retrospect bit off a little more than we could chew, but excited about the volume of home games and being able to stay in the state and continue our strength and conditioning development and probably help us academically too. So a little home cooking is always good.
When did you arrive at that conclusion?
Probably towards the end of the year. Just realizing that I think we could probably do the same things, but get a little bit more home friendly.
What do you feel like some of the failures and successes taught your team last year that you can carry over into this year with some of your returning players?
Well, you're always in the fight. That no matter who you're playing, it's always you're playing the game of baseball. So I think the ability to outlast people and hang in there and just have the courage to continue to take, again, one more step in front of the other, just even when it feels like you may not have that energy to do so. So just being able to finish, I think, is important.
Do you think ending on a high note last year, rolling over into this season, will help you and like maybe the morale, the mentality of the team, knowing like, look, we put it together at the end of the season, let's start on a better note this year?
Yeah, I think it shows them what's possible. I don't know that it necessarily carries over. We've got 28 new players, and they've got to find their way too. So I'm sure we'll absorb some bumps and bruises again along the way. But certainly, I think what it says to them, it certainly says to me, is that no matter what, you just continue to play, and things can happen. So as long as we have breath in the lungs, we're going to continue to fight. So
you mentioned the 28 new players. Just what's the challenges of having that many new faces on the roster?
Yeah, I think it's kind of the nature of roster management today. The portal's changed everything for better and for worse. You know, I think it's going to affect the high school players in a negative way, but it'll provide opportunities for those that maybe didn't have an opportunity where they came from. So, just trying to have them assimilate themselves into our culture and our standard and our brand, I think, is probably the biggest thing. And we've had great leadership this fall, so I think that's really helped the transition.
Yeah, I mean, I
think you play the game. I mean, you play the game to win. So, I mean, we're trying to go out there and win a regular season championship, and then obviously the only vehicle to the postseason is winning the conference tournament. But it's always where you finish. Again, as we found out, how you finish is what's most important. So, I mean, we can use it as fuel. Something to prove, people disbelieving, and it's part of it. So I'm sure the guys will use that a little bit, but it's not going to matter when the umpire says play ball on day one. So.
No LSU in your schedule for the season. Mm-hmm. What was the sort of thing behind that, I guess?
We just couldn't work it out this year. So we'll continue. Jay and I are good friends, and we'll continue to see how we can manage that moving forward.
And Logan Hurd, who's the brother of Thatcher Hurd at LSU, like what was sort of what does he sort of bring for you guys?
He's an electric left-handed arm with a great breaking ball. So he's had a great fall, and excited about what he can contribute.